everyone! In the previous video, we saw what a wife is, how to install the battery, how to charge it, and explored its various power input and output modules. In this video, we are going to explore a wife's plug and play interface and perform some fun activities with DC motor, servo motor, and touch sensors to understand it better. Let's begin. A wife's hassle-free plug and play interface makes connecting components such as motors, servos, touch inputs, etc. easy and lets us control them directly from the menu. This makes understanding their working and testing them easy and efficient. To understand it better, let's control the DC motor using a wife. For this, we'll need a DC motor and a wheel. Mount the wheel on one of the two shafts of the DC motor. Now let's connect the motor to a wife. A wife has two inbuilt motor control channels, namely M1 and M2. The two pins at the top form channel 1 and the bottom two corresponds to channel 2. Let's connect our motor to channel 1. In the case of the DC motor, we need not worry about polarity. Thus, connect it either way. Now switch a wife on. From the menu, select controls by pushing the navigation key to the right. Then select motors, then motor 1. As soon as you select motor 1, the terms PWM, DIR1 and DIR2 will appear on the screen. Here, PWM stands for pulse width modulation. It is a type of output signal that is used to control the speed of the motor. DIR1 and DIR2 stand for direction 1 and direction 2, indicated by either a 0 or 1. Here, 0 means off and 1 means on. The direction can be changed using the slide switch. If the slide switch is in the center, then the motor is off and therefore the status LED is also off. If it is in the upward direction, it will rotate in one direction and the status LED will turn yellow. And if the switch is in the downward direction, the motor will rotate in the another direction and the status LED will turn red. Turn the potentiometer knob to change the speed of the motor. Now disconnect the motor and go back to the main menu by center pressing the navigation key. DC motors have a wide range of applications in project building, be it a turntable, a color sorter, or a stair climbing robot. Now on to the servo motor. A servo motor is used where we need to precisely control the rotation angle. This micro servo can be used to rotate any angle between 0 and 180 degrees. Take the servo horn provided as a part of the servo accessories and attach it to the servo head. Attaching the servo horn will help us better visualize the rotation. Now let's connect the servo to a wife. A wife has two dedicated servo motor channels, S1 and S2. Connect the servo to servo channel 1. Make sure that you connect the brown wire to the leftmost pin. Now switch on a wife. From the menu, navigate to control and select servos, then servo 1. The eWife screen displays the angle of the servo, which can be controlled using the potentiometer. Turn the potentiometer knob to observe the change in angle both visually and on the screen. You must be extra careful of the input supply if you are working on an external power supply such as a DC adapter or an external battery, as the servo motors work on a maximum voltage of 6 volts. The higher voltage may blow up the servo. To make sure it does not go beyond 6 volts, regulate the power supply using the VVR knob. Now disconnect the servo motor and go back to the main menu by center pressing the navigation key. Servos can be used to make fun projects that require precise movement, such as this Angry Bird themed intrusion detection system, automatic door, or the biped robot. Now, let's have a look at the eWife's inbuilt touch sensors. eWife's touch sensors are located under its magic lid. Carefully remove the lid to take a look at them. At the bottom left corner, you will find 12 pins. They are numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 11, 12. By connecting a conductor to any one of the 12 sensors, you can make its surface touch sensitive. see how this works, we are going to make the surface of a fruit touch sensitive. For this, we will need a male-to-male jumper cable and a fruit. Connect one end of the jumper cable to the first touch sensor and insert the other end into the fruit. Now, switch on Evive. From the menu, navigate to touch sensor using the navigation key. Make sure that you do not touch the fruit while navigating. After selecting touch sensor from the menu, touch the fruit. In doing so, Evive's buzzer will make a sound and the screen will display the corresponding number of the touch sensor. Touch sensors can be used for making touch sensitive projects like the fruit piano, virtual drum set, the touch-based switchboard, etc. Well, that's all for now. In the next video, we'll take a look at the features that truly make Evive a portable electronics lab. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such engaging videos, subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Bye-bye!